While you're out in costume looking for some candy, we went out in costume to look for some Kickstarters. I am, of course, the Purple Hooligan from the Dinosaur Island board game.
And I am a Quilt from the Patchwork board game.
In these costumes, we hope to find some great Kickstarters for you in this week of October 29th for our Kickstarter Pickstarters. As time has passed, human culture and societies have grown. And if there's one thing we have mastered, it's trying to prove that our civilization is the best. Be prepared to hear that word a lot from me during this pick. Monumental has you take on the role of a major civilization, and you will use your warlord, soldiers, and explorers to carve your place on this modular board. You will build outposts, defeat barbarians, push back your opponent's armies, and build wonders. This all really does sound like Civ, which actually has already been made in not only in an older board game, but also has been remade by Fantasy Flight. But Funforge decided to throw their hat in, and from what I can see, it looks pretty good. In this game, not only are you moving pieces along this board, as I said, is modular, there is a deck-building mechanic. But instead of having cards in your hand, you set them up in a sort of grid. Each turn, you choose which row and column to activate, so you can leave some cards in your hand for maybe different turns. The cards you buy from the common row will have the wonders I mentioned before, such as the pyramids, or later on, Statue of Liberty, and is actually separated into eras. Once again, we're feeling a lot like Civ here. This really brings some cool ideas to the table I liked in this form of you have this different sort of laying out your cards can sort of change out the pattern. It looked really fun to think instead of just playing your hand out. If you think of most deck building games, you have to think like, I'll choose this row and this column for resources.
Yeah, no, that's definitely interesting.
I thought that was really cool. And another small thing I think for me is a big thing. We saw this, I've seen this one before. Maybe this has happened more often in Kickstarters, but they actually have different pledge levels based on ones without minis, with little tokens, and ones with minis. So you can save a little bit of money. The money in question is $30 for the base, and about $15 you save for not getting minis in the expansion. Mm. The base itself, though, still will take about $70, if I recall, and $100 with minis. So that's still not... It's still expensive, but it's pretty good savings.
I feel like it's almost a good sign when you're making a civilization-building game. That big of a price tag indicates to me that, oh, there actually is the depth and the amount of content in there that that kind of a game, I think, requires for it to really be satisfying.
Right. Hopefully. And the expansion does add four new groups. I say the base, I think, if I recall, is Egyptian, Chinese, like Japanese, and Greek. On the expansion, I think, was Amazonians, Atlanteans, India, and I'm blanking on what the fourth group
no
was.
No, America?
No.
Boycott!
But the expansions have heroes, and one of them is Albert Einstein.
Close
Don't
enough.
Know the heroes. And so I think that's pretty cool. And what this is actually supposed to be, all of it is a Kickstarter exclusive. Not just the expansion or some things. They have decided that this will only be done through Kickstarter. It will not have major release. So if you want this game, you gotta get it now.
Skulk Hollow is a game from Eduardo Barath and designer Keith Matejka, who also did Role Player, a game that we're really big fans of. Skulk Hollow, it's a two-player asymmetrical game that is sort of a Shadow of the Colossus-esque, I would say, in its themes, in that there are these giant creatures known as guardians that one player is going to be controlling, just one of these guardians, while the other player takes on the role of foxen, cute little fox woodland creatures with little fox meeples, and they're going to be trying to take down the guardian. The guardian actually has its own board, sort of reminded me of what we saw in the Attack on Titan card game, although that was a vertical stand, this is just flat, but you can climb up the guardian, there are different spots for its head and feet, etc., and attack it from different vantage points. There's also a special map that's just where all your pieces go, so the one player is recruiting new units, sending them to different parts of the field, moving them, attacking with cards that are have two actions on them, and you have to choose one of those to use, which is a mechanic that I think we really like whenever you see, you have to make a choice on what you do with the card, whereas the guardian is moving around, of course, trying to take out the little guys. They also have special individual goals because there are multiple different types of guardians, and depending on which one you choose, you might want to take out a certain amount of the foxen, or you might want to try to, if you're, for instance, there's one that burrows underground, and you want to burrow in a certain amount of places, and different kind of cool thematic aspects that will change the way that you play. So even if you play a bunch of times, you might have different units, different guardians, etc., going back and forth.
Yeah, when doing these Kickstarter Pickstarters, we sort of look at our own first and then put ours together. And I came across this, and this is definitely on my list. I'm like, you know what? I bet Jonathan's going to pick this.
And you were right.
It had all the telltale signs. You know, it looks really cool. I mean, the asymmetrical board is really awesome. We enjoyed the way the Attack on Titan works. So seeing that sort of again, though, I mean, while we don't get the cool standing vertical board, I still think it's really cool they can do that. And unlike Attack on Titan, you get different boards for different Guardians. The only problem I really have, unless there's something hidden in the story, is Guardians, like... If they're bad, you could have come up with, like, I think a better name. That's, like, my one qualm with it.
Yeah, they should have been called the Evilers. I don't know. No, I see where you're coming from. But anyway, it looks pretty darn cool. Got a good track record on it. If you want to check out Skulk Hollow, it's for $39. Could suit your two-player gaming needs.
Some people try to protect the world, whether it's the downtrodden, the environment, or the pursuit of knowledge. To others, life is just business as usual. Offworld has you take on the role of a megacorp, who is done reaping the earth for its resources and is out to explore the universe for profit. You'll be doing so by 4Xing, exploring, expanding, exploiting, of course, and maybe a little extermination along the way. The board expands depending on how you expand, so there's no guarantees what you may uncover. And when you do find planets, there's an event deck with some good things and possibly bad. But of course, don't forget about your home planet, because events happening back on Earth may stir things up. Actions will be played with special cards that can either be used for currency on one side, or actually special actions on the other, so you have to decide whether you're going to pay or play. This did look really fun in sort of the different actions you can do and sort of deciding, like as we said earlier, deciding whether you're going to use it for money or for actions. Mm-hmm. Each company is actually unique too, so they are sort of designed to force you to sort of play a special way. And there are hidden goals, which is something both of us approve of because that sort of helps keep everyone in the game in terms of points and stuff because you don't know if you're in the lead or behind or whatnot. Mm-hmm. And of course, that lets you do some more hidden things, which makes actually is very thematic if you think about these megacorps. So if you're looking for this game from Post-Industrial Games, it'll take about 63 real US dollars. But there are some cool expansions along the way as well and some minis. But if you're looking to be a little bit greedy, this may be the game for you.
It wouldn't be a Halloween Kickstarter without a couple of creepy ones. Thousand-Year-Old Vampire is a solo RPG from Tim Hutchings, who did the game Dear Leader, which was a goofy party game that we've talked about on our channel before. This is a very different type of game, not comedic, very serious, very dark, very weird, where you play as a vampire, and you're sort of keeping a journal, a log of your adventures throughout time. It can be played with multiple people, but it is really designed as a solo game. You have a certain number of stats. For example, memories are one of the kind of the special things that you have that play a big part in the game. And as you go, you've got a character sheet as well as a log, and there are going to be different prompts that come up that you need to respond to. And the prompts vary wildly. You can see some of them on the Kickstarter page. They can be very in-depth. They might say, you meet a new friend, and you come up with an idea together, and this happens. And there will be a couple of gamey things in there, like you gain a resource, or you gain a memory or something. But then you're supposed to kind of write down and respond and think about what you actually did, what you're doing, what your reaction to this prompt is, and how it develops your character. And as that goes on, things can change. You can actually lose memories because you're a vampire, you're getting older, and as you go, you might forget about things that are important to you. So it's one of these games that's kind of really trying to be this artistic endeavor and make you like think about yourself, your soul, who you are as a person. There is a template draft up there right now that you can try out for yourself. All the reactions to it have been really strong, really positive. It's the kind of thing I'm really excited about. The idea of the solo RPG, I think, is a really cool one, especially from like we've been playing the solo graphic novel adventure books that it came out from Van Ryder Games, and this is, you know, I don't think it's too far of a stretch to a traditional role-playing game, that kind of a thing.
And to me, the idea, because using the vampire, while it is spooky, the idea, because it's always curious when you see them in the older ones, in shows and stuff, because hearing their sort of opinion sometimes of, like, what it has been like for them to live through, like, World War One and Two, like that's, I think, for Wolverine is like that. And I think that's when he becomes more interesting. I think that old Logan is that. Yeah. When they talk more about like, what is it like to be immortal, so to speak.
Yeah, that's another thing too, is that it's not tied down, locked down for you what type of vampire you are. So you could be like traditional, you could be like a Nosferatu, you could be like, it could be a Twilight vampire, you know, like your makeup and your stats are sort of your thing. So it's your character, and that's kind of neat. So of course you can get the digital version only for $10, or you can get a physical copy of the book for $25.
Starling Games would like to invite you to the Taurus Institute, where you will expand your science horizons and absolutely nothing will go wrong. Absolutely nothing. Okay, maybe a little. In this game, one player will take on the role of the anomaly, the horrible, terrifying unknown that is hunting the other players, which are the science students. You are all in the station trying to defend yourself from the anomaly or hunt down the other players if you are the anomaly. But no one knows where they are. While there is a large board in the center, you will all be having your own little maps behind a sort of player board where you'll be tracking your own movements. You'll also be putting out cards in front of you that sort of show your path where you last been in different areas so people can sort of guess where everyone's sort of been last. I thought this was really cool. We've always loved hidden role movements. So to see everyone have the hidden role movement is really funny and interesting.
Yeah, I mean, obviously there's a sucker for that. And of course, the sci-fi being hunted by alien kind of theme.
If you watch actually our video on our suggestions for horror games, our number one pick was that, in essence, everyone's also hidden movement.
Yeah, an escape from the aliens in outer space.
But this takes it up, I think, a different notch because it's not a simple, when that was just a simple move or attack and done, there's a lot more going on. Mm-hmm. Because this is a 1v1, of course, if you know many of those games, you know, you'll do it. The big group will do actions that feed the other group. Mm-hmm. They have a similar mechanic in this, but what happens is if I play an action like setting a trap, I then give that card to you, which on the other half has an action for you. Mm-hmm. So it's not simply I'm giving you energy. I know exactly what I'm giving you, which to me, I think adds a really good twist because then it's like, is it worth for me to give you this evolution card?
Right, right. No, that's cool. I like that a lot.
And that's really awesome. But the location itself isn't safe for everyone. The nuclear reactor in the center is cracked, and every turn it's going to sort of radiate an area. And if anyone's there, it hurts them, including the anomaly.
Okay.
So there's a mixture of randomness there, not knowing and trying to guess where people are with movement, plus choosing actions based on what cards you have to give to the anomaly. It just feels like that perfect next step that we wanted in our list of horror board games.
I'm excited.
The game goes for $39. Not the first game for that price. But if you're looking for a game and you enjoy 1v1s or hidden role movements, I think this is an anomaly that stands above the crowd.
Another Kickstarter you might want to check out this week is The Edge Dawnfall from Awaken Realms, which I think we've probably already talked about in the show. I can't actually remember. But it's a new edition or a new printing of that game, which looks really cool. So maybe check that out. Or any of the other ones that we talked about this week. Or let us know in the comments below what you're backing or not backing. I think there are some really exciting ones that we're both interested in putting our dollars into. Until we see you for the rest of the week, have a spooky, spooky time wherever you are and whatever you're playing. I'm Jonathan. That's Will. I hope. And this is Roll for Crit Kickstarter Pickstarter. Oh no.
Make sure you click the like and subscribe buttons so you get more board game content from Roll for Crit.
Do it. Do it now.